We are beginning tonight with the Salinas shocker, Mayor Dennis Donahue's annual State of the City address today.
Which actually turned into a surprising announcement that the mayor will not seek re-election when his term ends in November. We have team coverage, beginning with Action News reporter May Chow, who is live in Salinas.
The mayor's shocking announcement overshadowed much of his State of the City address. Holding back tears, Mayor Donahue told a packed room that this would be his last year in office.
I am honored to have served this great city. This will be my last State of the City.
After 6 years and three terms, Mayor Dennis Donahue gave his last address to a packed theater Friday at the Maya Cinemas.
I am humbled and grateful for the years you have allowed me to work for you at City Hall. Now it is time for me to focus on being a husband and a father. Yes, even grown-up children miss their dad. And get back to my goal of making sure radicchio and other chicories become one of the top 10 crops in Monterey County.
His emotional announcement came as a surprise to everyone in the room, including Congressman Sam Farr, who introduced the mayor and city leaders.
I'm shocked. I'm very shocked. Yes, yes, yes. I'm very surprised. And like I said, he's one of the best mayors we've ever had, and he's done a lot for the city of Salinas. And I just hope he changes his mind.
It's really a sad day for Salinas in my mind. One of our great leaders. I'm just hoping that he will stay in some way in the civic scene. And he's just a natural leader, and he needs to be part of leading the community.
Just totally surprised. Totally surprised. But I think his remarks were dead on. You know, he's been working hard to bring about so many of those things, to address all the issues, and it'll continue. I mean, still got a great cast of characters involved.
I'm absolutely shocked. I had no idea that was coming in.
Deputy Police Chief Kelly McMillan says the change in leadership might halt safety and violence projects that were spearheaded by Mayor Donahue.
Salinas is at a really fragile time right now. We've got a lot of new and very progressive initiatives underway that are really really have a high potential to affect the issues that are affecting Salinas.
But the mayor says he won't be disengaged during his final term and will not abandon his goals and plans for the city.
I've got you know, the better part of 9 months ahead of me, and for an opportunity to continue to serve. And you know, the agenda for Salinas doesn't change in my mind. We want to be more peaceful. We want to be more prosperous. We've been laying the foundation plank by plank.
And again, the mayor told me that he will continue living here in Salinas and that he'll also continue being a part of the vision, Aaron, which he laid out 6 years ago. Aaron.
All right, May, thank you. Well, as May said, much of the announcement today was overshadowed. Much of the City of the State address was overshadowed by the announcement.
Absolutely.
Today.
Our team coverage continues with Action News reporter Tom Miller with more on the city State of the City address.
Well, Dan, the mayor didn't outline many specifics of his long-term vision for the city, but he did paint the picture of Salinas continuing to grow and being well-positioned for the future.
Today I have one message to convey. We're changing Salinas.
In his final State of the City address, Salinas Mayor Dennis Donahue says the city is poised to take over as the epicenter of the entire Central California coast, not just Monterey County.
Salinas historically has been the business and government capital of Monterey County. And we are now positioned to update that for the 21st century and emerge as the capital city of the emerging Central Coast regional corridor that extends from the Tri-County area that Congressman Farr represents in the north to Ventura County in the south.
He says it'll happen by improving the city in key areas, although no specific plan was laid out.
Economic development, a commitment to community policing, expanding a tax base, building strong neighborhoods, and delivering city services. These are our new management team's fortes and our city's priority moving forward.
It wasn't all positive, though. He pointed out a very low officer-to-resident ratio and admitted that the city is riddled with crime.
Despite our progress, it remains my best judgment we are not on a sustainable course to meet the public safety needs of our city.
At the end of his speech, he talked about compromise, saying some like ice cream and some like cake.
What about ice cream cake? No matter what hard choices we may weigh, and no matter what hard times we may face, we all share a common vision of safety, prosperity, unity of our great city, and ice cream cake.
And sticking with that food theme, the mayor also added that he expects Salinas to continue to be a leader in both the food production and food safety industries in the years to come. Dan.
All right. Thank you very much, Tom. We have much more detail on the mayor's speech on our website at ksbw.com.